हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण विल ट्राई टू हियर टुडे दिस नेक्स्ट ऑफ डिवोशन ऑन 21st अक्टूबर 1972। जय राधा माधव कुंड बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज
बिहारी।
यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन। यमुना तीरा
वनसा
तीरा वे, जय राधा माधव कुंज
बिहारी।
जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर
धारी,
जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर
धारी,
यशोदानंद ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदानंद ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरा
वनसा,
यमुना तीरा वनसा, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज
बिहारी।
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सो वी विल बी गोइंग टू हियर द श्रील प्रभुपाद लेक्चर ऑन टॉपिक नेक्टर ऑफ डिवोशन ऑन अक्टूबर 21st 1972 इज गिवन इन वृंदावन।
They just now have received for newspaper cutting. This is from South Africa. What is the city's
Durban.
Name?
Durban.
So, these two young Goswamis, they are preaching very successfully in South Africa. And another news I've got, where it is from Midwest of America. Another two Goswamis, they are having very successful meeting in Midwest America. In South Africa, their boys, what is the age of Rishi Kumar?
20.
Yes, his age is only 20 years. Rishi Kumar Goswami left, and Khudidas Brahmachari, they have come to South Africa to spread the word, Krishna message for SA, South Africa. So by the grace of Lord Chaitanya, the message of His Lordship is going on nicely all over the world, and you are also members of the society. Try to preach this message. Prithivite ache jato nagaradi gram. And you will get strength the more you preach, because in the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, Nachatasmat manusyesu kaschit me priyakritam jaimam mad bhaktesu abhidhasati. Anyone who is preaching the message of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Krishna, the same thing. There is no difference. Krishna says that sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam saranam. This is Krishna's message. And Lord Chaitanya says, jare dekho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. So there is no difference. Krishna's upadesh is to everyone, that everyone should give up all nonsense type of occupation. Kamastasta hitajnana jajanti anna devata. Those who are attached to the worship of demigods, they have been condemned by Krishna. Hitajnana. Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur has commented on this word, hitajnana, nasta buddhaya, those who have lost their all intelligence. So our Krishna consciousness movement is preaching the same as Lord Krishna said and as Lord Chaitanya said. Lord Krishna said that you surrender. He asked everyone, not only Arjuna, through Arjuna, He spoke to everyone. Kauntiya pratijanihi name vrakta pranasyati. He was preaching His own word through Arjuna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, He is Krishna Himself, He is preaching the same message as devotee. So our business is to preach the same message through the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. So if we follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu means to follow the six Goswamis. This is called parampara system. Evaṁ parampara prāptam imaṁ rājasayo vidu. If we follow the parampara system, the same message, what Krishna said, that is also said by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that is also said by the Goswamis. Sri Rupa Goswami says, jena tena prakarena mana Krishna nivesa. Samavarada. Try to induce people to become Krishna conscious. This is Goswami's, Rupa Goswami's message. Where you are sitting, this is Rupa Goswami's place. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also says the same thing. Jare dekho tare kaho Krishna. So these boys, Rishi Kumar Goswami and others, Satsvarup Goswami, Hidayananda Goswami, they are preaching the same message, Krishna message, in the paper. Krishna message in South Africa. Krishna message in South Africa. This is very encouraging that Krishna message is being spread as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu desired. Jare dekho tare kaho Krishna Vadesh. This is very encouraging. So all of you, of course, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu entrusted the matter to all Indians, especially. Bharat bhumite manushya janma hilo ja, janma sartha kuri karo paropoka. The best welfare activity is spreading this Krishna consciousness movement. So, it was entrusted to all Indians. Any Indian who has taken birth as human being, it is the duty of him to spread Krishna consciousness. But anyway, although there is only one Indian, you follow and spread this message extensively. After this Ujjabrata, you will also disperse and go different parts of the world and spread this Krishna consciousness message. The Krishna consciousness message is Krishnastu Bhagavan Sayam. There is no other Bhagavan. Bhagavan means full of six opulences. So Krishna is completely 100% full of all opulences. Even Narayan is 96%. And Lord Shiva is 84%. And Brahma is 78%. These are calculated by the Goswamis. So Krishna is 100% Bhagavan. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Matta Paratanam Nanyat. Nanyat. Nobody. So, simply, you have to, just like our little girl Saraswati, she also preaches. She goes to some friend. She asks, do you know what is Krishna? If he says, no, I do not know very much. So he says, the Supreme Personality of God. That's all. This is preaching. It is not difficult. Simply, just like the child, you go, everyone, talk to everyone that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. That's all. Everyone can do it. It is not very difficult. You believe it. You be convinced on the statement that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Ishvara means controller, governor. So there are governors, many governors in your country, but they are not supreme governor. Everyone is governor. You are also governor or Ishvara, controller, but not the supreme controller. Our message is that here in this material world, there are many controllers, many governors, many Ishvaras, but nobody is the supreme Ishvara. Supreme Ishvara means he has no controller over him. He has no controller over him. He is the supreme controller. Here everyone is controller, but he has got another controller over him. But even big demigods, just like Indra, Chandra, Surya, Vayu, Varun, they have also controller. Even Lord Brahma, he is also controlled. Only Krishna or Krishna Tattva, Vishnu Tattva, he is not controlled. He is the supreme controller. So Ishara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarva Karana Karana. This is our message. No? Read. Why don't you keep open? No, there is no other problem. Go on.
Bhakti rasa can be understood by a serious student upon studying the nectar of devotion. Adoption of bhakti rasa or Krishna consciousness will immediately bring one to an auspicious life free from anxieties and will bless one with transcendental existence, thus minimizing the value of liberation. Bhakti rasa itself is sufficient to produce a feeling of liberation, because it attracts the attention of the Supreme Lord, Krishna.
Yes, people generally think that liberation is the ultimate goal or the full achievement. But liberation is a very insignificant thing in the presence of devotional service. Therefore, Bhagavad says, dharma prajjita koitava atra. Dharma artha kam moksha. Moksha means liberation. So, Bhagavad says that dharma artha kam moksha, they are thrown away from the study of Srimad Bhagavatam. And Siddhartha Swami confirms it, atra mokhovancha pojyantam nirastam. A devotee is above the point of liberation. The devotional service is called pancham purushartha. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given his opinion, prema pumartha mohan. Not dharma is pumartha. Our ultimate goal of life is neither dharma nor artha, religiosity, economic development, kama, sense gratification, and moksha, liberation. So people are very busy for economic development. They think that is the highest goal of life. Get money somehow or other. And then after getting money, to satisfy the senses. And when they are defeated in satisfying senses, defeated means everyone is trying to satisfy his senses to the greatest extent. Unfortunately, Maya will not allow him to do so. Devijisha gunamai mama maya duratya. Therefore, Bhagavad says, parabhavastavad abodha jata. Parabhava, the karmis who are trying to satisfy their senses to the highest limit, they are being defeated. It cannot be. Nobody is satisfied with his senses to the greatest extent. In Europe and America, this can be very practically experienced. Many old men, very rich men, 75 years old, 70 years old, they are still going to the club for satisfying senses. That means the sense satisfaction business cannot be completely done even up to the point of death. There are many stories we have got practical experience that Akbar Shah inquired from his one of his very confidential and minister that how long a man is sexually inclined. So the minister replied, up to the point of death. He replied, Akbar did not believe it. But the minister sometimes took him to a man who was just going to die, and the minister requested Akbar Shah to get with him his young daughter. So when the Akbar Shah and his daughter was entering, the man on the deathbed, he was looking to the young girl, not to the Akbar. So he pointed out, just see, and he was convinced, yes. So the sex life is so strong that you cannot be satisfied if you remain in material existence, then this sex desire will never be satisfied. But it can be satisfied only when you come to Krishna consciousness. This Jamunacharya has said, Jadavadhi mama chitta krishna padaravinda navanavadhamarantumasi tadavadhi batanari sangames marjamane bhavati mukha vikara sushtu nishti varancha. Sri Jamunacharya says, since I have been engaged in serving the lotus feet of Krishna, from that time I do not anymore have any desire for sex life. Even if I do remember of sex life, I want to spite on it. So this is the result. Krishna is Madan Mohan. Madan Mohan, Madan Cupid, he agitates everyone for sex life. But if we actually be attached to see the beauty of Krishna, then we shall never be enamored by the arrows of Cupid. Parang dishtani vartate. So, what is the subject matter?
Thus minimizing the value of liberation.
This is the position of the materialistic person. Therefore, sometimes they take to the path of rejection, giving up. Brahma, Satya, Jagan, Mithya. They come by knowledge, by advancement of knowledge, but sometimes that also becomes failure. Even liberation, I have several times explained that many persons on the platform of liberation also falls down. Arujya kritchena parang padang tataha patanti adha anadrita jusmat angray. One who does not take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, even he is raised to the platform of liberation, there is chance of fall down. Arujya kritchena parang padam. Parang padam means liberation. Not material platform, but param padam, spiritual platform. A spiritual platform means liberation. So, unless one is attached to Arichakichena parangpadang tata patanti adha. Why they fall down? Anadrita jusmat angraya. One who neglects to worship the lotus feet of Krishna, even he is on the liberation platform, mukti, there is chance of falling down. And there are many examples. One.
Bhakti rasa itself is sufficient to produce a feeling of liberation because it attracts the attention of the Supreme Lord, Krishna.
Yes. As soon as you are engaged in the service, loving service of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, immediately you feel liberation. This is practical. When you are fully engaged in Krishna consciousness, even if you walk on the street, you will feel that I am separate from these persons. I am walking on a different path. This is the feeling. Bhakti parasanu bhava. This is bhakti. Parasanu bhava. You will experience yourself. That is the test. If you experience yourself that I am different from these persons, then where is the attachment for material things? So that is the test, how much you have become advanced in devotional service. You can experience yourself. The example is given, just like a hungry man, if he is given food, if he eats, then he experiences himself that he is getting strength, his hunger is being satisfied. These things will be experienced. He hasn't got to take certificate from others whether I am advancing in spiritual consciousness, Krishna consciousness. He'll feel himself. Bhakti parasanu bhava virakti annatrasya. This is the test. Just like Goswamis, the six Goswamis, they were ministers. How they gave up their lucrative service engagement. Tattva turnam masesa mandalapati saning sadat tuchava. They gave up their minister high post, association of aristocratic families, mandalapati sreni. They were themselves not only mandalapati, great leaders, but they were associated with great leaders. But they gave up everything. Why? Parang drishtani vartate. They found something better in Krishna consciousness, therefore they are able to give up, just like you are. You are European American boys. You are accustomed to better, comfortable life, I know. But you have given up your better, comfortable life and you have learned, or you are satisfied lying down on the floor without any bedding. How you are being practiced to eat? Because you are trying to find out a better engagement. Parang dishtani vartate. Sometimes in your country they are surprised how we are living without furniture. Because without furniture living is impossible. Sometimes in the beginning, when I was accommodated in some apartment, the landlord used to inquire, "Oh, where is your furniture?" So they do not know, they don't require furniture. We can lie down anywhere. It doesn't matter whether in a nice apartment or underneath the tree. That doesn't matter. So how these things happen? Unless one becomes little advanced, one has got little taste in devotional service, they cannot give up this material comforts. The Goswamis are the best example. They were coming from very, very aristocratic family. They did not join the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement out of poverty stricken. No. All of them, six Goswamis, just like Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, they were very, very big men, ministers, very rich men. Similarly, Raghunath Das Goswami, he was the only son of his father and uncle. And at that time, his father and uncle had 12 lakhs of rupees income. So you cannot imagine what is the exchange of 12 lakhs of rupees 500 years ago. So, very rich man. Similarly, Sri Jiva Gopal Bhattan, Sri Jiva Goswami, he was the jewel of all learned philosophers. That is acknowledged even by the greatest philosophers of the world. So, these six Goswamis, they were not ordinary men. But still, for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's service, they left everything. Taktva tu namasi samandalapatin sadastu ucha bhutva dina ganesa kaukaranaya kaupina kanthasito. So, Krishna bhakti, devotional service of Krishna is so exalted that a devotee can kick out even mukti. They do not want, a devotee doesn't want. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, na dhanang na janang na sundaring kavitang ba jagadisa kamay. Mama janmani janmani shari bhavata bhakti rahuituki. So, devotion and service, this line of activities should not be taken for some material gain. That is not bhakti. Bhakti must be pure, 100% pure, free from all material desires, free from the resultant action of jnana and karma. Anna vilasita sunnam jnana karma anabhita. In other words, if you are actually a devotee, you will have no more interest with this material desires. Material desires means dharma, artha, kama, moksha. They are all material desires. Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, of course, it is spoken by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, bhukti mukti siddhi kami sakali asant, Krishna bhakta niskam, atayam sam. That is the taste of Krishna bhakta. He has no desire. He does not want to exchange anything by serving Krishna. That is not pure devotion. You can exchange. You can get the result. Therefore, Shastra has recommended, Bhagavata has recommended, akama sarvakama ba moksha kama udaradhi tibrena bhakti yogena jajita paramam purusha. Akama. Akama means these devotees who have no desire. Annavilasita sunnam. That is called akama. And others are kama, not akama. Others who bhukti mukti siddhikan. Those who are desiring for material gain, bhukti, and those who are desiring after mukti, liberation, they are also kami. And those who are desiring after siddhis, yoga siddhi, anima laghima siddhi. So all of them are kamis. They are not akama. Therefore, Bhagavad says, akama sarvakama va moksha kama. Sarvakama means karmis. The karmis have no end of their desires. Bring money, bring money, bring money, bring money. You have seen, you have got good experience in your country. millionaires, multi-millionaires, still working hard. Where is money? Where is Diva Charte Haya Rajan Kutumba Bharanirma? These materialistic persons, they are engaged at night either by sleeping or by sex indulgence. Nidrayahyati naktam babayena cha babaya. They are wasting their time, valuable time of this life, either by sleeping or by sex at night. This is their night's business. And what is day's business? Diva charte haya raja. In the daytime, simply walking or running by cars. You have seen in your country, there are flyways and always cars, hundreds and thousands of cars. Sometimes I think that so many cars are going this way and so many cars are going this way, why they not settle up their business by telephone? I do here, your business I do here. But that is not possible. Because it is karmi, all of them running this way, and there is accident. So many thousands, how many thousands they die every year? There is statistic, yes. So this world, material world is like that. The diva charte haya rajan kutumba bharanenava. And as soon as they get money, they want to purchase. The wife says, I want so many dollars for my this purpose. All right, take it. The children says, therefore in the Bhagavad, they are called sajanakha dosu. Dosu means burglars. So the wife and children, they are legitimate burglars. Yes. If somebody takes your money from the pocket, he becomes pickpocket, criminal. But if your wife takes it away, he very become pleased. How my wife is nice. So they are called sajanakha dosu. It is taken as love. How much my wife loves that he is taking all my money from pocket. So, diva charte haya rajan kutumba bharanenava. This is the occupational duties of the materialistic person. But a Krishna conscious person is not like that. They say that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, the ideal Krishna conscious personality of Godhead, the supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya Namne. Bandi Mahapuru, what is that? So, Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya Namne. Namo Mahavadanaya, Krishna Prema Pradayate. Krishnaya, Krishna Chaitanya Namne. He is Krishna. Simply, he has taken the name Krishna Chaitanya. Otherwise, how one could give Krishna Prema? Krishna Prem can be given by Krishna, nobody else. So, Namo Mahavadana, this is the first verse, sloka, uttered by Srila Rupa Goswami when he met Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at Prayag, modern Allahabad. Prayag is also named there. So, he offered his prayer like this, Namo Mahavadana, Krishna Prema Pradaya. He understood that here is the incarnation of God who is the most munificent. Most munificent, other incarnation of God. Even Krishna could not give Krishna prema. He simply ordered that you surrender unto me. Not that you take Krishna, love of Krishna. No, he did not give. Therefore, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, Krishna came again, that I did not give my love. So he came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, anarpita charing chirat karunayavati nakalo. Anarpita charing chirat. In other incarnation, the Lord Ramchandra, Lord Krishna, they did not give. Of course, those who are devotees, they automatically. But their purpose was different. Paritrana sadhuna vinashaya chadushkita. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, incarnation of Godhead Krishna, he specially came to distribute Krishna prema. That is the special significance of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Namo Mahavadanaya Krishna prema pradayate. Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namini Gauratisi Namo. So, we shall always, you have taken the path of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He will bless you if you sincerely stick to his principle, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then by his grace, he will be able to preach his message as these boys, they have been given sannyas and very, minor age, and still they are doing very nice. You are all of you, you are very minor age, but take this Krishna consciousness. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also himself took sannyas at the age of 24 years. It is not that one has to accept sannyas in ripe old age like me, 70 years or 75 years. Not that. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu set up the example that for Krishna's service, one can take sannyas at any time. So he did it by his personal example. Takva turnam, there is a verse. Just now I forget that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave up his opulent family life when he took sannyas. At that time, his wife was only 16 years old, and he had his affectionate mother, Sachidevi, very old. Nobody was to take care of him, her. But still, he took sannyas giving mercy to the poor human society in this age. Therefore, he is called Namo Mahavadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayati Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namini Gauratisi Namo Namo. So, you follow the instruction of the Goswamis, follow the path of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and try to spread Krishna consciousness all over the world, and your life will be glorified. Thank you very much.
Prabhupada ki jai. So let us have small discussion on this topic. Prabhupada's explaining on this matter devotion on 21st October 1972. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Prabhupada got the newspaper from South Africa, city of Durban. For the two Goswamis, Sasarup and Rishikumar Goswami, they are preaching very well there in South Africa. They are only 20 years. They come from the very Buddha, Krishna's message from South Africa, essay. So, Prabhu Krishna, Prabhupada is mentioning how this great Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is spreading all over the world nicely. And all the members of society should preach this cult of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prithvityachayata nagarati grama, you will get strength. The more you preach, the more you will get the strength. Because Krishna says, Nachatasman manushesu kaschit me priyakatama. This is very dear to Krishna. Anyone is preaching myself to Chaitanya Krishna, same thing. There is no difference. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Krishna is the same thing. Because Sarvadharma Pratima Mekam Sharanam Bhada, Krishna's message is the same thing. Yarade Katarade Krishna Upadesh. There's no difference. Krishna Upadesh is everywhere. Everyone should give up all types of occupation. Kamas Tirtha Gnana Yanta Devataha. And they have been condemned. Tirtha Gnana, Sri Vishnu Chakrakarta commented that Tirtha Gnana means Nasta Buddhaya. Those who have lost their all intelligence. So our Krishna consciousness is preaching. Same thing that is Lord Chaitanya and Krishna is wanted. You surrender, he asked everyone, not only Arjuna, through Arjuna, he spoke to everyone, Kaunteya Pratijanati, Nai Bhakta Pranashita preach the own word for Arjuna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Krishna himself, will preach in the message in the form of devotee. So our business is to preach the same message through the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Yaradeka Taraga Krishna Upadesh. So if you follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is to follow the six Goswamis of the Prabhupada. Six Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all these Goswamis. And there also same message. Rupa Goswami says, Yana, Yena Tena Prakarena Maha Krishna Niveshayat. So somehow that try to induce people to become Krishna conscious. This is Goswami, Rupa Goswami message. Where you are sitting, this is Rupa Goswami Samadhi. Classes happening there. So yeah, they get Krishna Pradesh. So the boys, Rishikumar Goswami, Samadhar Goswami have this. They are preaching messages like Krishna messages. They appear in paper. It's very encouraging. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there they get Krishna Pradesh. So all of you, of course, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu interested matter or any especially Bharata Bhumite Haila Manusha Chanmaya Janma Sataka Kari Karaparaputa. The best welfare activity is spreading this Krishna consciousness movement. So it was interested to the all Indians. Any Indian who has taken birth in human beings, it is the duty of him to spread Krishna consciousness. But anyway, although there is only one Indian, you follow and spread the message extensively. After this Urja Vrata, this Kartik Vrata, you all disappear and go to different parts of the world and spread the Krishna consciousness movement message. The Krishna consciousness message is Krishna is the Bhagavan Swayam. So you go everywhere and say Krishna is the Supreme Personal God. That is the Parishana. Krishna is complete said person God, neither Lord Shiva, neither Brahma, neither anybody, because they have 96-84. Brahma is 76, but Krishna is only 70% God. So you say Satta Pratam Nanyat. Nobody is so simply you have to say. So example, the Saraswati, mother. She is preaching. Who don't know Krishna, then Krishna is the Supreme Personal God is the preaching. Talk to everyone, Krishna Supreme Personal God, that's all. Everyone can do it. It is not very difficult. So you believe it. You be convinced on the statement that Krishna Supreme Personality God here. Ishvara Parama Krishna, Ishvaram is controller, there are different controller governors, but Krishna is only supreme controller. Nobody is controlling him. Ishvara Parama Krishna, Sachitananda Vikrahana Dharana Govinda, Sarva Karana Karana. There are no controllers. So already keep the book open and read. So in Bhakti Rasa can be understood by serious students who are studying the nectar devotion up to the Bhakti Krishna consciousness will immediately bring all auspiciousness from all activities, will bliss by the transcendent language, thus minimize the value of liberation. Bhakti Rasa itself is sufficient to produce the feeling of liberation because it attracts attention to the Supreme Lord. So people generally think that liberation is the ultimate goal, but full achievement, but liberation is a sincere good thing in the presence of devotion service. Therefore, Bhagavad says, Dharma Purjita Kaita Vatraha, Dharma Artha Kama Moksha. Moksha means liberation. The Bhagavad says, Dharma Artha Kama Moksha is thrown away from the study of Bhagavatam. Sridhar Swami confirmed it. Atra Moksha Vancha Paranya Nirastam. The devotee is above the point of liberation. The devotee service is called Pancha Purushartha. Chitana Bhagavad Param Prema Purmahan. Not that Dharma Purmartha. Prema Purmartha. Ultimate goal of life, Dharma Artha. Religious figure. No, Kama Moksha liberation. So people are very busy economic development. So they think that the highest goal of life is to get money somehow or other. They're not getting money, satisfy senses. Then they are defeated, satisfying senses. Defeated means everyone trying to satisfy senses is a great restriction, but unfortunately, Maya will not allow them to that. The way Shikunam Maya Birataya. So Parabhavastaste Bodha Jataha. Parabhava. Karma is who are trying to satisfy the senses, the highest limit. They're being defeated. It cannot be nobody satisfied with senses. The greatest extent in America, this can practically experience many, many old marriage men, 70-year-old, they're still going to club for satisfactions. That means in satisfaction business cannot be completely undone until the point of death. So there are many stories who have got practical experience that Akbar Shah inquired from one of his confidential minister that how long this sexual inclination is there, Mr. Chen. After the point of death, they reflect, but do not believe. The times comes when he brought the one Akbar daughter girl in the world. He still has sexual desires. So this is practical. You can see. So sex life is strong that you cannot be satisfied. If you are remain material existence, then sex desire will never be satisfied. Then you can satisfy only with Krishna consciousness. Yamunacharya says, Yad Vadimama Cheta Krishna Padar Vindayo Nava Nava Rasadhamni Udyatamarantam Asit Navadhamni Bhatanare Sangam Samratam Pavati Mukhakara. Krishna says, by present Krishna Lotus Feet from the time to time, the desire of sexuality is manifest. Remember, sex life is not spit it off. This is Krishna's Madan Mohan, Madan Mohan Mohini, Cupid, agitators of sex life. actually attached to Krishna beauty, then we shall be immortal or stupid. Paramat Dushta, this subject matter does minimizing the value of liberation. Yes. So materialistic person, they sometimes they take a rejection, giving up Brahma Satyam Jagat Nityam. There's only come by they come by knowledge, by advance of knowledge, and sometimes they become failure, even liberation. I have several times explained many people for liberation. One who does not seek to grow shakti, he has to be a path of liberation. There is a chance of fall down. Spiritual path means liberation. So unless one attached to Krishna, one who neglects worship the lotus of Krishna, then liberation from mukti, there is no chance of falling down. There are many examples. Bhakti rasa itself is sufficient to produce feeling of liberation because it attracts attention of the Supreme Lord. Yes, as soon as you are in a service, loving service quickly got a heart. Immediately you feel liberation. This is practical. When you are fully engaged in Krishna consciousness, even if you walk on the street, you will feel that I'm separate from that person. I'm walking on a different path. This is the feeling. Parishanubhava. Bhakti means you will anubhava. You will experience yourself. That is a test. You experience yourself that I am different from this person. Then there is attachment for the material things. So that is the test. How much you have become advanced in devotional service is experienced yourself. The example is given like hungry man. If you heat yourself, you know there is nobody to give certificate for that. So he feels himself bhakti parayasana virakti annyatra yashat. There is a test. The six of Goswamis, they are minister. They are given a great post. Highest post associated with the Atishka families. Mandalapati, only Mandalapati great leaders, they have given up everything. Why? Pradishtanivartan. They got higher test, Krishna consciousness. So like we are Europeans and Americans, we automatically are constantly better comfortable now. But you have given up your better comfortable life. You have learned, that is, lying down on the floor without any bedding. You have been fatigued because you are trying to find a better engagement. Sometimes in your country, they are surprised how we are living without furniture. Because without furniture, living is impossible. Sometimes in the beginning, when I was accommodated in some apartment, and landlord used to inquire, where is your furniture? So they do not know why they don't require furniture. We can live on down anywhere. It does not matter whether nice apartment or under a tree. That does not matter. So these things are happening. Unless one becomes a little advanced, one got a little taste device, they cannot give this material of what to see. The Goswamis are the best examples. They are come from different families, but they are staying one tree, big ministers. They have lakh rupees incomes, but still have given. They cannot imagine the exchange of 12 lakhs rupees 300 years ago. So very rich man, Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Gopala Bhattacharya Goswami, all learned philosophers, they got everything give up. Ordinary man, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu service, left everything. Krishna Bhakta devotees, no exalted devotee, not kicked out of the mukti. Do not want. Devotees want Krishna service. Nadanam, Najanam, Nasundarim, Kavitam, Vajagadisha, Kamayi, Mama Janmani, Janmani, Shari, Bhavati, Dairi, Tattva. Devotional learning activities should not be taken as some metal gain. It is not bhakti. Bhakti must be pure, 100%, free from all material desires, free from the result action of jnana and karma, anya blasada shunyam. This would actually devotees. No material desires. Material desires, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. They are all material desires. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna Kaviraj, of course, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, bhakti, mukti, siddhi, kama, shakale, ashantha. Krishna bhakti, nishkama, atave, ashantha. There is the best test of Krishna Gupta. There is no desire. He does not want to exchange anything by serving. That is not true devotion. You can exchange, you cannot dissolve. Therefore, Sasa recommends that Akama Sarva Kama Moksha Kama Udharate Tivran Bhakti Yoga na Yeda Paramamu. Akama means no desires, Nablajus no Akama, no Poama, Bhakti Mukti Siddhi Kami, all the Kamis. Therefore, Bhakti is Akama Sarva Kama. The karma is no end to their desires. Bring money, bring money, bring money. You see, they have got experience. Millions, millions are still working their money. Where is the money? Miserable there in night, either by sleeping or by sex indulgence. Nidra hudaya nakta vayandhu, they're wasting their time, valuable time. Either sleeping by sex night business, the day's business. You have seen in your country, clover flowers, hundreds and thousands of flowers. So why they don't stay in one place? They have to go here and still they're not satisfied. Then, I want so many dollars, but Bhagavatam Sivan, there is this burglars, wife and children, they are legitimate. Burglars, they are thieves, pickpockets, they are in the wife, they are so nice. On the thief. These are materialistic duties. Krishna can not look like that. So then Mahaprabhu says, Namo Mahodanya, Krishna is giving Krishna himself. Krishna taking Krishna Chaitanya is giving Krishna Brahma is the greatest sloka. Rupa Goswami is much Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Mahamahodhanya. Rupa Goswami is much Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is giving Krishna Brahma. All other incarnations never give, but the Krishna Chaitanya only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving this name, Krishna Prema. So, Namo Mahodhanya, Krishna Prema, Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya, Amana Gurudishi, Namo Nama. So, we shall always take the path of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and follow the six Goswamis by His grace. We have to preach, become sannyasis. Allah took time. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took himself 24 hours. Then his wife is only 16 years. The affection of Sachidevi. Nobody take care of him. Still, he took sannyas for the mercy of the poor sinners that in the East. He said, Namo Mahodhanaya. That is very simple. So, proper request to follow the instruction of Goswamis, follow the path of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, try to spread Krishna pass all over the world, and your life will be glorified. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this is the conclusion of Nectar of Devotion by Srila Prabhupada on October 21st, 1972. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much.